Hi, my name is Amy Klingler, and I'm a PA in family medicine at the Salmon River Clinic in Stanley, Idaho. I want to take this opportunity to talk to you about the importance of screening for mild cognitive impairment and Alzheimer's disease in primary care. This provides a real opportunity for us to catch cognitive impairment and Alzheimer's disease at an early stage. And let me tell you, we're not doing a very good job right now. About 90% of patients with mild cognitive impairment are missed, which means we're catching their disease later and we're missing opportunities to intervene and administer therapies and lifestyle interventions that can really make a difference for them. And so we want to take the opportunity to always screen our patients 65 and older for cognitive impairment. We can do this as part of their annual wellness visit because Medicare actually pays for it, but we can also do this at any time. The assessments can be at 88, the mini-cog, and some PAs may choose to get upskilled and learn how to administer the Montreal Cognitive Assessment, which is a more comprehensive test that can be relatively easily administered in primary care. It's also really important to think about our patients under the age of 65. Many of them have concerns about memory issues, or they may already be exhibiting signs and symptoms of cognitive impairment. So anytime a patient expresses concern, it presents an opportunity to do a quick screening and either make a preliminary diagnosis, identify a need to refer to a specialist or for medical imaging, or actually reassure your patients that what they're experiencing is normal brain aging. We all forget where we put our keys, and we all forget what we walked into the room for. But as patients get older, they start to worry that this may be a sign that something more serious is going on. So it presents an opportunity to have a conversation and make it part of the annual screening, so your patients know that you're going to talk about it, and that gives them the opportunity to bring questions and concerns to you. As you can imagine, when you give a patient a diagnosis of mild cognitive impairment or Alzheimer's disease, you can get a whole spectrum of reactions. In the next video, we're going to talk about how to have that conversation with your patients and their care partners.